CDC has published guidance on this topic. It is important to both clean and disinfect frequently touched objects and surfaces throughout your workplace. Think about employee workstations, keyboards, touchscreens, telephones, handrails, two-way radios, doorknobs, faucets, sinks. Dirty surfaces should first be cleaned with soap and water before the disinfectant is applied. When you are disinfecting, please be sure to make sure the products that you choose meet EPA's criteria for use against COVID-19 and that they're appropriate for the surface. There is a link to the EPA registered household disinfectants on the CDC page, and that'll be a great starting point for you. Within our facilities, we've increased our cleaning frequency in all of our common areas. In addition, we've given cleaning supplies to each workstation to allow our employees to clean as they go, the beginning of the shift, the end of the shift, or whenever they feel appropriate. If you can't find disinfectant or sanitation wipes, you may use household bleach solutions if it's appropriate for the surface. Follow manufacturer's instructions for application, ensuring a contact time about 1 minute and allowing for proper ventilation while you're cleaning. Remember, never mix household bleach with ammonia or any other cleanser. Using unexpired bleach will be very effective against coronaviruses when properly diluted. If you're going to be using bleach, 5 tablespoons, which is 1/3 cup of bleach per gallon of water, or 4 teaspoons of bleach per quart of water. That will be the appropriate amount to disinfect the areas of concern. You can also use alcohol solutions that have at least 70% alcohol. But again, be sure your employees are wearing disposable gloves, you have proper ventilation, and you check with the safety data sheet to see if there's any other precautions you may take while using the products that you choose. Depending on the type of business you run, you may be required to provide additional training to your employees during the COVID-19 pandemic. One that comes to mind is OSHA's Hazard Communication Standard. That basically has employers providing information to their employees that are working with new chemicals, such as disinfecting materials. There's something called a safety data sheet that every manufacturer publishes with their chemicals that outlines what the right personal protective equipment is, what to do in case of a spill or emergency, how to properly dispose of any excess materials. Those safety data sheets must be kept, and you must train your employees to properly use the chemicals that you're asking them to use during this pandemic. OSHA has a really great guidance on this. If you click through CDC, they'll actually take you to the OSHA guidance on hazard communication. Another one that you may never have thought of before would be OSHA's Bloodborne Pathogen Standard. That training is typically given to janitorial staff, hospital workers, and medical personnel who have a much higher risk of coming into contact with blood or bodily fluids. But because of the increased cleaning and the potential exposure, at least at Pitney Bowes, we've gone ahead and we provided that training and awareness to our employees that are doing that disinfecting. A big part of that, again, is personal protective equipment and making sure that they're protected while they're doing the cleaning for us. Another training, more so an awareness that you may want to consider, sharing all the great things that you're doing to keep your employees, your clients, and the public safe during this pandemic. Social distancing signs, posters, hand washing, letting people know all the things that you're undertaking gives people a peace of mind and can hopefully alleviate some of the fear and concern. This can be a challenge. Pay attention to areas where employees can naturally congregate. Think about your lunchrooms, locker rooms, lobbies, break rooms, time clocks, and other high traffic areas. Start there. The use of visual indicators is really important. Having those marked off at 6-foot distances takes the guesswork out of it. Use signs, traffic cones, tape on the floor, stop signs, whatever you have within your facility to ensure that people can visually see the 6-foot distances. Talk to them about how important this concept is. In certain cases, you may need to engineer some really creative solutions to do this for your employees. One of the things that we did is we bought 6 foot long tables in for one of our break rooms. We spread them out at 6 foot distances and people sit on either end of the table. It takes the guesswork and the questioning right out of, am I at 6 foot distance? We're providing you that and making it really easy. Think about how your workflow is designed. Can you have less people in different work areas? Can you stagger your shifts? Can you stagger your break times? Can you have people go outside for breaks and lunches to eliminate, you know, congestion in those smaller spaces? Consider one-way entrances and exits. These are all things that we are working through. There's a lot of people going through the same challenges right now. OSHA has some guidance on social distancing. CDC put out some guidance on social distancing. Print that information and be sure to share that with your employees. Enforcing it, reminding employees, that's important to make sure that we're consistent and keeping everybody safe within our facilities. And that includes your clients, your customers, your employees. In light of new data about how COVID-19 spreads, along with evidence of widespread COVID-19 illnesses in communities across the country, the CDC now recommends that people wear a face cloth covering to cover their nose and mouth in community settings and in some essential businesses. Remember, this is to protect people around you if you are infected and you may not show symptoms. In certain geographies, executive orders have made these mandatory. Your employees can bring in face cloths from home. That would meet the executive orders in many of these cases. But as a business, if you are under a mandate, you need to provide these for your employees. At Pitney Bowes, we've done a combination of reusable cloth masks and disposable masks. Don't forget to remind your employees that they need to take proper care of these and how to correctly wear them and keep them clean.